Subject is Environmental Studies Part 1, Standard 4th. Today's topic is Lesson number 10, Cloths. Dear children, let us try to get the vast knowledge about the cloths. How they are made, what all is used to make the cloths, how they are cleaned, why they become dirty, etc. Okay? Children, we know that human beings have some basic needs like food, water, shelter, clothing and air, isn't it? Today, let us do the detailed study about clothing. This is one of our basic need. Okay? Dear children, here a small girl observing the cloth by using magnifying glass. Yes, this is called magnifying glass. This helps us to see the object 10 times greater. Okay, when we see the cloth by using magnifying glass, we can see the threads by which the cloth is made. These are called threads or yarns. Okay, like this pattern they have. Here the threads are intertwined. Here you can see a different type of cloth that is very shiny and smooth. It has also the threads. The threads of this cloth are soft and very thin, so we cannot see the intervening of this thread. Got this, children? Here you can see a sweater. Correct? In this also, we use the threads or the yarn to make this. Okay? Got this? Here you will see that cloth or fabric is made by intertwining threads together. Right? Just now we saw intertwining threads together is called weaving. Yes? What we call? We call it as weaving. Okay? Long threads are woven together to make cloth. How the cloth is made? Cloths are made by intertwining the threads together. Okay? That is called as weaving. Now, where does this thread come from? Just now we came to know that cloths are made by intertwining the threads or yarns. But from where does this thread come from? Yes? Okay. Now we will study about this. There are two different types of sources from where we get the material for the cloth. Number one is plant source, that is the material we get from the plant. And second one is the material we get other than the plant source. Okay, we will study about both these sources one by one. First, we will move to the material we get from the plant source to make the cloth. Dear children, here you can see a cotton plant. This is a cotton plant and this is called as cotton ball. Okay? I hope you have seen this. Right? This is called as cotton ball. Yes, here you can see a girl. She is using the cotton wad and she is stretching that cotton wad until it gets stretched. Then she presses and rolls that one. And when we do like this action, we get wicks, vati. These are called long wicks. We use this to light the lamps. Isn't it? Okay, and here we can do like this wicks also. They are called as round wicks. This also we used to light the lamps, isn't it? Means here the cotton is stretched, then pressed and rolled. So we got the wicks. Correct? Like that only by using spinning wheel we get long threads. Dear children, in earlier days like these spinning wheels were used to get the threads. And see here, the cloth is ready after getting the long threads of cotton. Got this, children? This is the process of getting cotton cloth from the cotton balls. Got that? Means a cotton cloth we get from the plant. Right? So the material source for this is plant. Now second one, the material source that is we get from the plant is this one. These are called as jute plants. Thin and tall, isn't it? These are called jute plants. From these plants we get jute yarn. You can see here in this picture a long thread. By this, after processing, we get jute threads, sutali, right? Okay, by using these threads or yarns, we make jute bags or like these bags. This is called as jute cloth. From where we got this one? Yes, very good. We got this from the jute plant. That is the main source is plants. Got this? Cotton cloth and jute cloth we get from the plant. Right? Now we will move to the material source other than the plant to make the cloth. Okay? See here. A caterpillars, larvas. Can you see? These are called as silkworms. White elongated caterpillars. We can see them on mulberry trees. Okay? They form cocoons or pupas around their body. Okay, here you can see the beginning of this and here you can see the cocoons or pupas. Okay, by the processing of these cocoons, we get silk threads. Okay, by using the silk threads, we make silk cloth that is very soft and shiny and very light. But it is called silk cloth. Yes, dear children, here these caterpillars or the silk worms helped us to get the silk cloth. Isn't it? This is the other than plant material which help us to make the cloths. Okay? Now one more is there. Here you can see the sheep. Right? We take out the wool of the sheep. Right? And we collect that one. And after processing this wool, we get woolen threads or woolen yarns. By using these threads, we make different types of sweaters. This is called as woolen cloth. This helps us to protect from severe cold, isn't it? It gives us warm to our body when we wear it. The source is the animal, that is sheep. Correct? One more. Now, here you can see these nylon threads. You can see here shiny, glowing, beautiful colored nylon threads. Right? And this is made by petroleum or tar, a chemical. From these types of threads, we get different types of synthetic cloths, that is nylon. See, this is nylon cloth, very light, shiny, and you can see this is called polyester. This is also very light, and here you can see the terlin cloth. These all are called as synthetic cloths because they are made up of man-made source, that is by using the chemicals. Okay, got this children? These man-made or artificial cloths, they are called as synthetic cloths. Okay, here we will make a list of types of cloths. Okay, whatever we have studied just now. First one, cotton cloth. Second, jute cloth. These two we got from the plant source. Correct? Number three, silk cloth. Number four, woolen cloth. Right? Number five, synthetic cloths. These three are made by using the material sources other than plants. Right? Okay. Now, we will move to the next one. Here you can see Mahatma Gandhi, father of our nation. Isn't it? You know that he played an important role in getting independence. Right? Okay. In order to win independence for our country, Mahatma Gandhi started a people's movement. He called upon them to use only those things that were produced in our country. For this purpose, he began to use a charkha or a spinning wheel to make thread. Charkha mandals were then established nationwide, which gave the message of using only Swadeshi goods. Swadeshi goods means made in India goods. Now also the same thing is going on, right? Our government asks us to use the made in India goods or Swadeshi goods, right? Here you can see the pictures of Mahatma Gandhi using spinning wheel to make the thread. Correct? Now, just now, we came to know that threads are woven to make the clothes. Right? Let us learn about the ways that the cloth can be woven. Okay? Now, first one, sweaters, caps, etc. are woven with the help of knitting needles at home. Here you can see a girl or a lady, she is knitting the woolen to make the sweater. Right? She is using the needles. They are called as knitting needles. I hope you have seen these type of needles and the knitting also. This is one way, that is by making sweaters or caps or any woolen dress by using the knitting needles. Second type is by using hand looms or power looms. See here, this is called hand loom. Here you can see the wooden structure that helps us to get the cloth woven. Okay, if we need the cloth in large quantity, we use hand looms and we use power looms. The power loom, here power is used to run the machines. In hand looms, the human work is needed, means they weave the clothes by using the structures, okay, wooden structures. But in the power loom, power that supply, it helps the machine to weave the cloth. Got this? Now next is one activity. First, take clean water in a small bucket. Here we will take two buckets full of water, right? Because I wanted to compare the water color, so I have taken here two buckets full of water. Okay, number two, soak the clothes you have worn all day in the bucket. We will keep one bucket aside. We will soak the clothes we used in the bucket. Okay, next, after an hour, take the clothes out of the bucket and before taking them out, wring them out tightly in the bucket itself. Okay, we will do this. Yes, see the color of the water. Yes, because we have taken out the clothes after an hour by wringing them out from the bucket. Now, children, tell me, by observing the water in the bucket, that the color of the water in the bucket is still transparent or still clean, or do you see any change in the water? Now we will bring the earlier bucket that was kept aside with the clean water. Now match the color of the water. Yes, correct. Again, bucket which we use to soak the cloth and we have taken out that one by wringing made the water dirty, isn't it? Yes, the meaning is when we use cloths, they become dirty, correct? Because of that dirt, the water became dirty. Okay, now we came to know that the cloths, they become dirty after using. Yes, now we will study how to clean them. Before that, we will try to know the reasons about how the cloths get dirty. See the pictures. Observe them carefully, then you will come to know the different reasons by which our clothes get dirty. See all the pictures. He is rubbing his dirty hand to the cloth, to his shirt. Here he is eating and spilling on his cloth or shirt. Here you can see the pollution, mud, dirt, correct, on the road. Here this boy is playing, that's why his cloth became dirty. Here also she is playing with her pet in the garden. Here this boy is painting. Here this girl, she is planting in the garden, right? Means each and every moment there is the possibility of getting dirt on our cloth, right? So our clothes get dirty. Yes, here see these two children, they are clean and tidy, isn't it? Wearing clean clothes is a good habit. We must always have clean clothes in order to remain healthy and look neat and tidy. Dear children, try to always use clean clothes which keep you healthy and attractive. Okay? Now, how to clean the clothes? First, with what do we wash our clothes at home? Our clothes become dirty when we use them. We came to know that, right? Now, how to clean them? How to wash them? What all we use to wash them at our house to make them clean? Yes, here you can see the detergent powder, right? Like Tide, Surf, so many types of detergent powder we get in the market, correct? And we get bars also, that also help us to clean our dresses or clothes which became dirty, right? These all we use at our home to clean the clothes. Now, what is used in the laundry for washing clothes? Sometimes we give our clothes to laundry to clean them or to wash them. What they use? Yes, see here, they use different types of washing liquids or detergents to wash our clothes. What this? Okay, now the third question is, which different types of soaps for washing clothes are sold in grocery shops? We bring different types of detergent powders and bars and liquids from our grocery shops to clean our clothes or to wash our clothes, right? Here you can see in the picture. These all we get at our grocery shops for cleaning our clothes, right? What can you use to clean clothes if these substances are not available in the market? What you will do? Yes? Guess? Okay, if you don't know, then I will help you here. We can use Ritas. Rita means here soap nuts. When we soak them in the water and when we stir the water, we get the lather like soap. Next is, this is washing soda. When we put this washing soda in the water and we stir this water, we can use this water to clean the clothes. Here you can see Hingenbaet. This is a fruit. This also helps us to clean our clothes. And the last one is limestone. Yes, dear children, these four we can use instead of our detergent powders, detergent liquids and soap bars. These are all natural substances that we get directly in the nature. Got this? They make the work of detergents or the bars. Yes, here are some questions that you have to answer. Do you still use the cloths you wore in the first standard? Now, dear children, you are in standard fourth. You have grown bigger, correct? But do you still use the clothes you wore in the first standard? Yes? Your answer might be no. I will write here. Okay? Okay, next is, if you do not, what clothes do you use now? Correct. New clothes. Right. Okay. Why do you not use your old clothes? What happened to them? Why you are not using them? You are right. Because old clothes do not fit you. Right? Do not fit me. Why can you not wear a dress now which was your favorite when you were younger? All of us have some favorite dress, right? You too have some favorite dress in your younger age. But it is not possible to wear that now. Correct? Why that is so? Yes, you are right. My favorite dress doesn't fit me because I have grown bigger. Yes, you became healthier and you became taller. Means you have grown bigger. So that dress will not fit you. Correct? Then what happens to clothes that we do not use anymore? We cannot use the small dresses, short dresses, isn't it? Then what happens to those dresses? Do you know? Yes? If you know, then it is very good. Otherwise, we will go through some points. Did you know that old clothes can be exchanged for new utensils? Yes, there are some people whose occupation is to trade old clothes in exchange for new utensils. You can see in this picture a lady with some steel utensils in her basket. Right? Here also you can see they are called as boharins. They exchange the old clothes by the utensils, steel utensils or by plastic items. I hope you have seen these types of ladies around you in your area. Your mother or your neighbors, they exchange the old sarees, shirts, pants, etc. or the children wears by the utensils, whatever they need for their house. Correct? They collect the old clothes from the houses and what they do? Do you know? Yes? We'll see here. Clothes are durable. Durable means long lasting. Therefore, even if they become old, they can still be used. Isn't it? If old clothes are still in a good condition, they can be given to those who need them. Here we can see the clothing donations. We can give these good clothes which we cannot use to like these organizations. Okay? Or we can give them to the needy people. Right? Number two, torn clothes can be made into useful articles like quilts or dishcloths or doormats. See here the patches of different cloths together made a quilt that we use for small children. Isn't it? That is made up of the old clothes. And here you can see the dish cloth. These old cloths, they are turned into the dish cloths. Mother uses these near the gas to clean the platforms, etc. Right? And this third one is doormat. Here also you can see the different type, different colored cloths together. It is weaved to make a doormat. You also can make this at your home by using the old cloths. Okay, this is the second use. Third one, old cloths can be used to make new cloth. We can alter the old cloth to make it new or to make useful for different purpose. Fourth one, threadbare cloths can be pulped and used to make paper. This you know, they are soaked and they are pulped to make paper. This pulp is used to make paper plates, see here, flowers, etc. It can also be used to make models. Right? This model is made up of paper made by using the old threadbare cloths pulp. Got this, children? So decorative, so beautiful flowers. These are made up of threadbare cloths pulp. Like this, we can use the old clothes in different purposes, in different manner. Got this? Okay, now we see diversity in clothing. Please observe the pictures here. Please observe each and every picture and the clothings of the couples. We can see diversity. These are all pictures from Maharashtra. Here, this first one is of tribal couple, and this is city couple. Here, these workery couples. This is farmers. Again, this is a tribe. Where this couple is ready for the celebration of party or the festival. Here, this is Koli couple, fishermen. Right? Why the dresses or the clothing of these couples are different? Yes, do you know? There is a diversity in clothing in Maharashtra due to cultural and geographical differences. For this, considering the climate, people in Maharashtra mainly wear cotton cloths. In some places we can see the hot climate, and in some places we can see the cold climate. So in Maharashtra, maximum people, they use cotton cloth to protect their bodies. Yes, in your house also, you can observe your parents, your grandparents, they use different types of clothes. There is also a diversity in clothing, isn't it? Your clothes are totally different from your parents' clothing, isn't it? What are these children? Means overall diversity is there in clothing. Now let us summarize what we have learned today in this lesson. Number one, cloth is made from yarn or thread. Yarn may be made from cotton, wool, etc. Right? Second one, cloths became dirty on being used. Must always wear clean cloths. To stay healthy, and to look neat and clean. Correct? Third one, soaps or natural substances like Rita can be used for washing clothes. Number four, old clothes should not be thrown away. They can be reused and recycled. Correct? We see diversity in clothing because of cultural and geographical differences. Last one, there is a difference in the types of clothing worn in earlier times and those worn today. Here you can compare your parents, your grandparents to you. Right? Dear children, we have completed this lesson. In this lesson, we have got all the information about the clothes, how they are made, how they are viewed, how they are cleaned, how they become dirty, what all we use to clean them. What about the diversity of clothing in Maharashtra, etc. Right? I hope you understood this lesson very well. Okay? Bye.